Hi, I'm always telling you how I run everything I can in Docker containers. I profoundly believe running stuff this way is far better than the alternative. Of course, I keep my server steady and data organized, but I'm also always watching for ways to improve things. And not so long ago, I happened to ask myself, am I doing this Docker thing the right way? Is there, by any chance, a better way? Could working with Docker be easier, more user-friendly, and basically more enjoyable? Sadly, and at the same time luckily, I found out I was doing it wrong the whole time. In ancient times, I got everything on my servers organized in many directories, trying hard to keep order in subdirectories, file names, and so on. If I wanted to do anything, I've got to SSH to the appropriate server and execute Docker or Docker Compose commands. True story, it worked fine. But, as you have guessed by now, there's a better way to manage Docker. Let me present to you the Portainer. Portainer is a web application that enables you to manage your entire Docker environment via beautiful, user-friendly web UI. Let's head to the computer.
I will show you a quick overview of Portainer on this home lab of mine. Just look at it. Simple, organized, beautiful. You will forget about using the command line for Docker in a heartbeat. And did I mention it's free? Yes, it is. At least the community edition on which you are looking right now. Isn't that awesome? Let's look at the features real quick. I've logged into my Portainer server, and this is the home screen everyone sees. On the left side, there's a menu with a few basic settings like users, environments, and you can see I've got no environment selected. I'll explain that later more in depth, but for now, let me just tell you that Portainer can manage Dockers on multiple hosts or environments if you want it to. In the main section, you can see a bar with news from Portainer, and below that are my environments that this Portainer server instance can manage. Local is the Docker environment running on this server, on this Raspberry Pi 4 on which this instance of Portainer is running. And the RPI 3B is the Docker environment that runs on my Raspberry Pi 3B Plus in the same home network. I can manage both of them from this one Portainer. But not to confuse you right from the start, just forget about the RPI 3B for now. If you install a brand new Portainer on your server, you will see only one environment, and that will be the local one. If you have a look at this environment, you will see basic information about it, as it runs on my Raspberry Pi 4, it has got 4 CPU cores, 4 GB of RAM, and so on. It's up, and I'm running 8 Docker stacks on it, which run 11 containers and use 2 volumes. And here you can see it's connected to the local socket at varran docker sock. Okay, let's dig inside the local environment. Right away, you can see a dashboard of everything that is happening here. Again, 8 stacks, 11 containers, images, volumes, network, and so on. And in the left menu, you can see in the local environment, app templates, stacks, containers, images, networks, volumes, events, and hosts. Let's start with stacks. Here you can see all the Docker stacks that run on this Raspberry Pi server. A custom Hello World, Home Assistant, Homebridge, Plex, WordPress website, and so on. If I open this WordPress stack, you can see it comprises of 3 running containers. WordPress app itself, VPDB, which is a WordPress database, and phpMyAdmin, which is a web UI for database administration. And you can see a bunch of information about each of these containers. You see its name, WordPress, state, running, quick actions to which I'll get back to, stack WordPress, image the container is using, IP address, published ports from inside a container, and so on. Now, let's have a look at the quick actions. You can access logs from inside a container. You can inspect the container itself. You can see live usage statistics, and this one is awesome. You can execute a new terminal right from the web browser inside the container. Look at it, it's beautiful. Okay, the next item on the menu is containers. This is nothing different than showing you all the containers running here. images are simply all the images pulled to this Docker host. Home Assistant Portainer itself, yeah, you guessed it, Portainer itself runs as a Docker container. Ubuntu and so on. Networks. These are Docker internal networks and you can also manage them from here. And last but not least, volumes. In these are shown the Docker volumes that containers are using. These are the essential parts you might need to manage your Docker environment. I encourage you to install Portainer and explore it. It's powerful yet easy and beginner-friendly web app, which makes diving into Docker world a much sweeter experience. And you don't have to study and remember every terminal command you need to work with Docker. Everything is a little bit easier when you can see what is happening and you can just click a button to do the complicated stuff. Let me show you how easy it is to fire up a WordPress website via Portainer. All you need is only the Docker Compose YML definition file. I'll provide you with one I'm using here. Okay, let's do this. I'll change the environment to my Raspberry Pi 3, which I use for this demo. You see there's nothing here except Portainer agent stack. Let's launch a WordPress site on this host. Hit add stack, name it WordPress demo. And you have a few options here. Use a web editor, upload a file, use a Git repository, or use a custom template. The quickest option here is to use a web editor and just copy paste the contents of the file I prepared for you. You see there are three services or containers here. Database, WordPress, and PHP MyAdmin. You can specify environment variables if you would want to, but we don't need it right now, and we don't need to enable access control. We're just fiddling around. Just hit deploy the stack. You can see deployment is in the progress. Right now, the appropriate images are being downloaded and containers started. And based on your internet connection speed, Portainer will deploy your stack in just a few moments. You can see the success notification. And now let's head to the web browser, put in the IP address of this host and port 8000. Isn't that nice? Copy and paste one file, hit one button, and you've got your WordPress website running. And this way you can run so many things. Wow, just imagine. I'll provide you with few copy-paste files to try out few things like Home Assistant, Plex Media Server, and so on. Check the links in the description below the video, okay? So finally, now the good part. How do you set up Portainer? Portainer itself runs in a Docker container. So everything you need is Docker installed and the Docker Compose YML definition file, which I'll provide you with. Again, check the links in the description. If you don't know how to install Docker, check out this video of mine or use Google to find a tutorial for your device. My way to do this is to create a folder for the Portainer definition file, make dir-p home docker portainer, change directory inside it, cd home docker portainer, create the dev file, nano docker compose yml, paste here the contents of the file provided, save and close the file, and now just launch the container. This is the last time you will need to use command line. Docker compose app-d. Wait a moment for the image to download and the container to start. And that's it. You now have your Portainer running on your computer. Let's head to the web browser and put in the address bar the IP address of the computer you run Portainer at and port 9000. Bam! Here's your Portainer up and running. Create username and password credentials. And look at it, your own Portainer home. Click on the local environment. And if you have any containers running on this host, you will be able to see them here. That's neat, isn't it? I know it's a little bit long by now, but let me just show you one more thing. It's great. As I've mentioned, you can also use this master Portainer to manage Docker on other computers too. You will see them here as additional environments. I'll show you in my home lab that from this Portainer environment, I can manage Docker on three different computers. One is Raspberry Pi 4 on which this main Portainer runs. The second one will be Raspberry Pi 3 running on the same network. And the third will be Ubuntu running on a virtual machine, again on the same network as those Raspberries. And you will be able to see them and manage them from here. You can even migrate containers between these environments with a simple mouse click. The only thing we will need to do is to run Portainer agents on those additional computers. The Portainer agent is a small container that communicates with the main Portainer. Again, you only need Docker installed and the definition file of the Portainer agent. Let me show you how to set up a Portainer agent. I'm logged in my virtual Ubuntu, open terminal and paste this one-liner to install Docker. curl-ssl get docker.com and pipe it to shell. Add my user to Docker group, sudo usermod-ag docker user. Relog to Ubuntu so the groups propagate correctly. Create Docker folder for Portainer agent. Make dir-p home docker Portainer agent. Change directory inside it. Cd home docker Portainer agent. Create the dev file, nano docker compose yml. Paste here the contents of the file provided. Save and close the file. And now just launch the container. That's it. Now the agent is up and running and we can add this new environment to our main Portainer. Let's head back to Portainer in the web browser. Home environments, add environment. Pick Docker and start wizard. Choose agent, fill out the name, let's say Ubuntu-VM. And the address in my case is 10.0.0.104. On the port on which the Portainer agent communicates is 9001, and just hit connect. And you see that the environment was added. Let's jump home and you can see three environments here now. Local is the Raspberry Pi 4 on which Portainer runs, RPI 3B, which I created beforehand, and finally Ubuntu VM, which is Docker with Portainer agent we just created in the virtual machine. So now I can manage all the environments I have available from this one place. And the last thing, let me show you how easy it is to migrate containers between these environments. To do that, I'll use one dummy container. Let's head to local and stacks. And the first one you see here is custom hello world. Let's say I want to migrate it to my new Ubuntu virtual machine. It's so super simple, I love it. Click on the stack to open it. And in this section, stack duplication slash migration, select an environment to which you want the container to migrate. Select Ubuntu VM and hit migrate. One warning that this migration does migrate container only, not the persistent volumes. That's okay, as this container does not use any persistent volumes. And hit migrate. Migration is in progress and the stack is successfully migrated. You can see it is now missing from the local environment, but if I go to home Ubuntu VM stacks, you can clearly see that the container was migrated to the new environment inside that virtual machine. How simple was that? Awesome, right? I love it.
So go ahead, play around with Portainer and let me know your feelings about it. I love it. If you need help with anything else, let me know in the comments. And if this video brought value to you, please subscribe to my channel, hit that like button and bell notification. Take care and bye.